Yo, what's up YouTube? It's Wilbur Walkins Photography and I'm back at it again today. Today we're going to talk about these and why they'll never love you back. Let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you like this content, before we get into it, don't forget to like, subscribe, hit that ring bell so you'll get notified when I do post a video. Today I just want to talk about cameras, lights, lenses, and models if you're into that type of stuff. So the beginning of this video I was saying that, you know, photography will never love you like you love it, right? So with that being said, I think that we as photographers, like, we get into this game and we'll see other photographers living a certain way. They're out doing exactly what it is that we envision for ourselves. And then with that, we'll begin to go out, pick up a camera, and start to live like an Eminem Lose Yourself video, right?
Palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already, mom's spaghetti.
Better lose yourself in the music, you know, doing all of that. And then you get into it and you're like, oh, this is not how I expected all of this to go. You know what I mean? So no one tells you that when you get into this, photography will never love you like you love it. You know what I mean? One day you'll go from feeling like you won an NBA championship to feeling like you want to jump off of a cliff. YouTube chill, I'm not promoting that, but that's the feeling that you'll get. Because you'll get one win and then you'll get knocked back on your ass, right? And then from there, you gotta decide, do you wanna continue to go? Or do you just wanna stay here and not pursue exactly what it is you set out to do? And that is one of the hardest things within photography, because she'll give you wins. She'll give you wins, she'll give you a win, she'll give you a win. And then she'll snatch it from you. And from there, you have to decide exactly how it is you want to move going forward. And that's with anything in life, really, but especially when it comes to this photography game. It's nights you'll lose sleep, you'll get creative blocks, you'll have to figure out how you're going to live from week to week sometimes. And nobody talks about these things, man. It's not all cameras, lights, lenses, and models. In a pretty lifestyle. In my 11 years of doing this, I've like experienced both ends of the coin. And I never once said to myself, except one time, and I had a friend talk me back from doing it. And I almost wanted to give up. There was this wedding I wanted. And because I was so inexperienced at the time, the clients didn't book me. And I was like, man, why am I gonna continue to do this? Nobody's ever gonna book me. I'm too young to be doing this. And this is just me talking from the heart, being honest, because this video is an honest interpretation of what it's like to be a full-time photographer and the things that I've experienced. I told him, I was like, I'm done. I'm not gonna do this anymore. So he kind of talked me back off the ledge. Since that point, in 2012 and 2013, I photographed over 175 weddings and events. So life gave me a choice at that moment. Do you want to give up and just walk away from everything you've invested in, or do you want to keep going? And now I'm to a point now, I'm still growing, I'm still going, I'm still learning. And with that, that's exactly what it is you want to do, because I'm telling you, just because you fall in love with this photography thing, it's never going to love you how you love it. And with that being said, I want to give you 5 tips on how you can continue going and not get caught up in just a downfall to the point where you want to give up. So let's get into it.
Round 1, fight.
Okay, so tip 5. I want you to walk away from the lenses and the cameras from time to time. I want you to put it down, go out, live life, and just give it a break. Because if you overly consume yourself with this, you'll get lost in it. So that's my tip 5. We're going backwards from 5 to 1. Tip number 1 will probably be the best one I can give you. But tip number 5, walk away from it. I want you to walk away, go go live life from time to time so that you can come back with a fresh mind on how you'll be able to proceed next with the next steps in your photography career. So that's tip number 5, walk away from time to time. Tip number 4, get a mentor. Stop thinking that you can learn everything from YouTube, even though you're up here on my channel right now, watching a video about photography. Go out, find a real life mentor who is doing this full time, who will be able to tell you how to do work-life balance, and you'll also be able to get the experience of working with somebody who's doing exactly what it is that you want to do and living the lifestyle that you want to live, instead of you dreaming it up in your head thinking that this is all pretty. Because like I said in the beginning of this video, it's not pretty. It's fun at times, but it's not pretty. So get a mentor. I don't care if you're not getting paid for it. Carry their bags. You know, hold their light stands. Ask them, can they teach you how to edit photos? And you say, hey, you taught me how to edit your photos. Let me drop by wherever it is that you edit sometime, and I'll edit some photos for you. You know, just go out, get a mentor, find somebody to learn from, and stick to them like glue. Because they're going to be the ones that will show you how to do exactly what it is that you want to do. Tip number 4, get a mentor. I'm dead serious about that. Get a mentor. Tip number 3, study life. Like I said, tip number 5, I wanted you to get out and live life, right? So for me personally, this is just me personally, and I want you to find your own way of doing this. I want you to study life, because studying life is going to make you a better photographer. I go to the mall a lot, and I'll look at ad campaigns, right? Of the fashion that's in the stores. I'll be out at restaurants and I'll study the lighting on people in the restaurants. Whenever I'm driving, I'm watching the sun move. This is why I wanted you to get away from photography for a while, because I want you to go out and study life. That's tip number 3. I want you to study life. Go out. Even when you're not working, you can be working, but you're also living life and getting your mind away from the camera itself and taking the photo. So study life, man. Go out and look at other images. You know, look at other images from ad campaigns. When I was in the weddings really hard, I would go out and I would study couples and watch how a couple interacts with one another out in public. Look how they hold one another. Look at how they interact with one another, how they hold hands, how he wraps his arm around her shoulder. These days, I'm more so studying ad campaigns. So when I'm out, I'll look at billboards. I'll look at a while ago, I was at a shopping mall, and Jennifer Lopez had a Coach ad that she had up. And I was studying how they lit that, and I kind of figured it out. And I might just go out and do my next tip, which is tip number 2. Tip number 2. Creative projects. So with creative projects, I want you to go out and do like I said in tip number 3, which is studying life and getting an idea of the type of things that you want to shoot. So when you do that, you'll be able to put together a creative project and create the type of work that it is you want to do. Like I was giving an example about the Jennifer Lopez Coach campaign. I kind of figured out how the lighting on that worked. So I might put together something like that and use that lighting technique, so that way that's in my arsenal. I have the images that I can use for my portfolio, as well as I put together a project that I wasn't paid for. There was no pressure for it. I was just being a photographer in the moment, creating and loving what it is I do. So that's what I want you to go out and do. I want you to make your own creative projects. Once you start getting hired for jobs, it's going to be so much harder for you to still love photography the way you do. You'll always love it because you have a passion for it. At least I hope you do. Don't just get into this thinking it's for play. Because like I told you in the beginning of this video, photography will never love you like you love it. And I mean that. So with that being said, in order to keep the love alive for it, you have to go out and create your own personal projects, especially when you start working as a paid photographer. So tip number 2. Do creative project. And my number 1 tip, never give up. I'm serious when I say that. If you really love this the way that I do, especially because I really care about photography, I really care about the industry that I work in, and if you want to get into this, even if you have been in this for a while and you may be feeling like you hit a creative wall or you just want to get to a point where you want to quit, don't give up. The world needs more creatives. The creative world has always kind of been disrespected. So I want people to always continue to go. Never give up. That's my biggest tip. Tip number one, never give up. Continue to go because you don't know what heights that photography can take you to, or even any other creative field. You have no idea the heights that you can go if you don't quit and if you continue to get better at your craft. So that's tip number one, never give up. All right, y'all, that's it for me today. I hope you liked the video. I hope you take those five tips and use them to your advantage. And always continue to love photography, because I'm telling you, it'll never love you the way you love it. That is the whole point of this video, the whole premise of everything. I don't care how much you love photography, it'll never love you the way you love it. So if you like this content, I'm gonna continue dropping these videos. I want you to click like, subscribe, click the ring bell, like I said at the beginning of the video. Also follow me on Instagram at Official Will Hawk, and I'll see y'all on the next one.